The difference between diversity and inclusion is diversity is just individual differences. Diversity just is. It's not something that really people can accomplish. It just comes with the space. Usually spaces are diverse without somebody having to be active or intentional about it. It just happens. Whereas inclusion is the active and intentional engagement of diversity, right? You see people for who they are, what they bring to a space, and how you interact with them is also a part of inclusion. It ensures that people get the understanding, the respect that they deserve. Inclusion helps benefit everybody. It's ensuring that systematically we are putting together a space that ensures that there's room for everyone to speak, be acknowledged, and also supported so that they get what they need. The difference between equity and equality. Equality is all about just ensuring that everybody gets the same thing. So you get three, you get three, you get three, everybody gets three. Equity is, all right, well, you get three because you need three. You get four because you need four. You get five because you need five, or you get one because you only need one. That kind of is related to like how we do in education. You know, we recognize that some people in education come with a higher level of understanding, and some people come to higher education with a lower level of understanding of college. And so how do we create spaces, right, to be more equitable? So I use the example of teaching 2 third graders how to read. If you have one student who is reading at a very, very high level, and you have another student who is reading at a very low level, do you teach them the same? Usually educators will say no. That's the difference between equity and equality. Equality says you teach them the same. Equity says you actually pay a little bit more attention to the students who is not reading that well, and then you challenge a little bit more the student who is reading well. Diversity and inclusion for me starts in leadership with self-work. So have you even done any social identity profiles? Have you done any education on race-related identity or social identity relating to sexual orientation, people with disabilities? You know, have you even looked into your own self to see what biases, what preconceived notions do I have before I start leading others? You know, essentially, a lot of times leaders, and I even made this mistake earlier in my career, we go into spaces and we show up and we don't even know how people see us. And we don't even see ourselves on how we show up. And so we come in and say homophobic, racist jokes that are absolutely, you know, just terrible, right? Or we come in and only talk to certain people, people usually who look like us, who make us feel comfortable. But the hard part about diversity and inclusion in leadership is when you notice that that person is sitting by themselves and not talking to nobody, the goal should be for you to reach out to that person, for you to see that person as a person who needs someone to say hello, to someone to support them or say, hey, I see you over there. Bring those people in. You know, that's the next step, is being able to call people in. Right, so sometimes that's just naming what you see. So I see a bunch of people who look like this sitting over here, and I only see a few people who look like this sitting over here. Did anybody else notice that? That might be a great way for a leader to open up the discussion and help us kind of break the ice as it relates to diversity and inclusion in leadership. You know, a lot of times we are all kind of come from spaces where we have an objective, we have a goal, especially when you're leading, you got a goal that you want to meet, and you have a certain amount of time that you got to do that. And I get it. Like, a lot of times we are just so much in our own head that we're not even thinking about all the people that are kind of like following us. When I see a leader who is kind of being a little exclusive, my goal is to not try to call them out. My goal is more to call them in. And so can I pull them to the side and say, hey, I noticed this about what you said. Did you notice that? Or even saying, hey, can I reframe that for you so it feels a little bit more inclusive to everyone that is in the room? This is a call in. So it's all about community space. And so I'm not saying, no, you said something wrong. I'm actually saying, this is what I noticed. I'm using I statements. You know, that helps de-escalate anybody who is feeling a little bit defensive. That also helps pull people in who feels a little excluded. Like, all right, they actually noticed that that person said something that was a little questionable. Sometimes you might even have to disrupt everything that is happening and say, I'm feeling something weirdness that is in the air. Does anybody else feel that? So you can give folk who are in the room space to be able to also say, yeah, I saw that, I noticed that. That helps you also build community because you are not the only person calling someone in. It actually is more people who is calling us in. That helps us actually create an amazing community.